Next speaker is Lee Ning, Senior Research Scientist, University of Alabama in Huntsville, who will speak to us about her research in gravity modification.
I think that anti-gravity, the word, is prohibited in physical society. If everybody talk about anti-gravity, the first game idea is just think you are crazy, you know, maybe stupid.
Could you keep the mic, use the microphone?
Sorry. The anti-gravity, so we talk about it with NASA. Avoid this kind of thing, so we choose the gravity modification. And Finland, I think most of you know the Finland experimental, they talk about gravity sharing. But I want to clarify that this physics concept from my paper published in 1991, the superconductor don't have gravity sharing. The penetration layer is very, very long, so gravity can penetrate into the superconductors. What's happened, why the gravity field is changing as observed it? Because the gravity inside the superconductor, like a transfer, they transfer EM energy to gravity energy. So arise the local AC gravity field. That's the gravity modification. We can change gravity, anti-gravity, or increase gravity. Also, we can change gravity in the any direction you want. That is my theory talk about. Fortunately, this theory already published in the 1991 Physics Review D. And then later we gave a little bit more detail in the 1992 in the Physics Review B and the 1993 in the Fundamental Physics Letter. I think the theory already hold there, you know, they published through the review process. Then that's very controversial. I know a lot of people criticize it, but fortunately, nobody found any mistake in my papers. So just about no mistake, but people don't believe it, I know. Until I got an experimental result I can show people, nobody will believe it because anti-gravity is an untouchable subject. So my husband one day said, you must have bigger guts, otherwise how you take this topic? Actually, I don't want to take this topic, but I will be talking about you how we produce this idea. That is, did you know, first bothered me a lot. I just asked me, what is the mass? What is the charge? You know, is everybody have the very simple answer for these questions? What is mass? What is charge?
It's energy.
Exactly.
Mass is matter.
Yeah, mass, you know, Einstein said M equals, E equals MC squared. Mass is energy. How about charge?
Is there a fundamental energy charge condition outside of the presence of an electric field?
Yes. If somebody notified the Puthoff in published paper in 1992, did you know in the vacuum suppose don't have mass, right? But they have EM field. This EM field can increase the mass. So mass is energy, EM field also is the form of energy. So the charge, you know, the EM form, the source should be the charge. So charge also the energy. Then next I asked me, if both of them is energy, just different form, can they transfer each other? The answer first is no. Because the electric field is a strong field. The gravity field is a weak field. They are in the different level. Did you know, in different level, people never talk to each other. they don't have common language to talk each other. They couldn't transfer communicate it. So then one day I calculated GPB, you know, everybody knows GPB. GPB is the Stanford, NASA supported Stanford research project since 1960. So no, Stanford GPB, gravity probe B in phase B. They pass phase A, so go to phase B. What is it really magic? You know, let me a little bit talk about it. Because this problem is very controversial, I really not dare to present it to you very detailed about my experimental work. I just hope you can excuse me. Maybe next year I can bring the data, you know, my experimental show you. But today I just want to explain the principle, use very common sense, not very deep physics. So I hope can everybody understand it. Then give me support. And so these two fields. Do you have this? Okay. Okay. So we talk about these two fields cannot talk each other because they're different level. But how they can I found just a superconductor, make they are the same level. Not a strong field, not a weak field, it's the same field. How they can do it? Let us talk about. Look, this is the mass, this is the charge. That's all of the particle we can solve the mass and the charge. And that's the field, that's the electric field, that's the magnet field. We call the gravity have the gravito electric field, the gravito magnetic field. Very similarly to the E and the B field. That actually is wave. You know, that energy is have two forms. One form is particle, one form is wave. Right? So okay. So we know in the vacuum the electric field and the magnetic field, they can produce mass. That is a put out theory, you know. And NASA headquarters gave me his paper, let me, you know, to review it. Then I calculated, then found his final result is correct. And that is 27 pages calculation. And finally, I use half a page, you know, can get produce his result. Actually, that's the Lorentz force. When the force times velocity, they become energy. So you calculate energy and they use this form, you can transfer the mass, you know. So that gave me clue. They said the unified theory, the electric, the gravity theory is can unify with the electric magnetic theory. But the problem is that the charge is have positive and negative, right? The mass always positive. So far, we didn't find the negative mass. That gave us the only opportunity. Superconductor, because they have the electric negative charge, electrons, and have positive charge, lattice ions. So these two, the superconductor like the solid plasma, you know. Everybody knows the superconductor is developed by the BCS theory. BCS theory got a Nobel Prize. Only BCS theory is talk about is the lattice ions motion. Did you know? Every electron, they just consider electron motion.
They nobody talk about the lady's eyes. They just frame. They say that they are in the rest because their mass is so big. But in superconductor, only in superconductor, the lady's eyes motion must be considered. That's another reason, and let us talk about it a second. I'm a little bit nervous, you know, so
sorry. That's okay, you're doing well. Heavy stuff.
So let us talk about, okay. We need to go to detail again. So we will talk about superconductor later. Let us lay down the foundation. Okay. What's your problem?
You mentioned that from superconductivity. Does this mean that experiments to test this can be done for hundreds of thousands or billions of dollars rather than millions of dollars?
No. I'm not talking with money.
No.
I don't have the concept of how much money will be worth. But I just explain the thing.
Can you do experiments to test this today?
Yes, we're just in process. I will show the result to you, a first stage some result. But not, actually, Finland already did it, already test. I think everybody see the London Sunday Telegraph issued the brokers through the news. They said that the gravity can control it. They mentioned the Finland experimental mentioned my theory, you know. And I want to explain that about money. I really don't have an idea.
I was asking about money. I was just asking, can the experiments be done today? Yes,
they can do, and we don't spend a lot of money, you know. And so let us see the gravity field. The gravity field has two kinds of gravity. One is what we call the DC gravity. That's the Earth stick all of us on the Earth, right? That's the mass produced gravity. And another thing is look about when mass moving. When mass moving, they produce the gravity magnetic field, right? Well, when the electrons, when the electron moves, they produce magnet field. The mass moving, they will produce the gravity magnetic field. That's all of the GPB doing because of the Earth's rotation, right? Rotation is the moving. Then they rotated, they must produce gravity magnet field. So GPB try to send, some instrument in the space to measure the Earth produce the gravitational magnet field. That's all about it. Is there a question? Okay.
Is this Earth's magnetic gravity field? Does that come out of general relativity?
Yes, 100 years ago, Einstein already predicted there have the gravitational magnetic field when the mass moving will produce, but very weak. So that's not a very accurate formula. I just want you get a fundamental idea. This field is determined by the mass. That is Earth's mass. That is the rotation velocity. That is the distance from the center of the Earth to the observer point. And so that is the BG field. When this field, if the variation with time, they will produce what? Produce gravity, right? That gravity is AC gravity. So there have two kinds of gravity. Is one is DC gravity, is mass produced, like the Earth's gravity stick on the Earth. And another one, if we can let mass moving produce the gravitational magnetic field. And this field, the variation with time, they will produce the AC gravity. That AC gravity is naturally is the same as the gravity, so we can control any direction. Is that the fundamental? Okay.
If
the experiment you are referring to, is that the Stanford experiment to put a gyroscope in polar orbit?
No. We are not there to do so expensive experimental work. Did you know how much it costs for GPP? This year, I think $53 million. Since 1960, so far already 35 years, you know, any year this kind of money. So we do very simple. I will explain later what we will do. Okay.
Since the Earth is rotating, how much of the gravity that we experience here is from this AC gravity?
Okay, that's not gravity. That is graviton magnetic field. The GPP gave you 84 million arc second per year. Actually, it's 10 to minus 15 percent. That this field, let me talk, this gravity magnetic field is nothing, just inertial frame the rotation rate. How they change the inertial frame to rotate it. So is the Earth rotated everybody know Earth mass is maximum. Let us see what the result are. So I want to explain there have two kinds of gravity. One is AC gravity, one is DC gravity. What I do, I want to produce AC gravity, you know, to balance or to control the DC gravity. That's not the people usually say the anti-gravity, because the Earth's mass is maximum. You know, one day I talked with Professor Everett in Stanford University, and when he saw my papers, he asked me one question. He said, the Earth is maximum mass we can find on the Earth. How you say you can produce the field is larger? I told him I can produce a field six-fold larger than what he wanted. He really surprised. He said, the mass is very large. I told him, yes, sir, mass is maximum, but your rotation, the omega is very small. You know, one day per cycle, every day knows the Earth, you cannot let the Earth speed fast, you know, just one day per cycle. And the R, you must leave the Earth to the space, the R is very large. How about we just choose one nuclear, and let nuclear spin. Nuclear spin very fast, it can go gamma ray, very, very fast. I can observe very nearby how much gravity field I can get. So I use the same formula, let's Stanford use it, calculate it, use any data put in the experimental result. And I got the same order about the large BG field as the Earth produced. They don't just believe it, but I said, look, any calculation, the number, I'm right. Then, unfortunately, the nuclear motion you cannot look at. You cannot see it. Why? Because the any molecule, that's the nuclear, right? They surround them have the core electrons, like the cloudit, you know, cover the nuclear. So nuclear motion is covered by the core electrons. So any nuclear motion you cannot see from outside because of the core electron cloud will cover up. So when you want to do the NMR, you must resolute it, you know. You cannot see in the solid. But when I saw BCS theory, they are only got Nobel Prize because they think they predicate in the superconductor the lightest eye. Actually, the nuclear motion can be observed, can show up. What mean? That means that all of the core electrons, like the clothes, they frozen in the nuclear. When nuclear motion, they must follow up. They never can cover it. So the light is I, the nuclear plus the core electron, they call the light is I's. That become like the particles. Is one particle have bigger mass, have the charge, have the vibration. They can free, surrounded their balance position, can vibrate it. And I got a good idea, but this idea, first one reveal come back and say, never heard the light is I can rotate it. You are the first one to do it. That's stupid. That's flawed idea. You know, they gave me, but I said, if they can vibrate it, why not they couldn't rotate it? Special the magnet field. And another thing is very, let us say another one. So the superconductor provide the only window let us to see the gravitation field. Why? Because in there, there's a core electrons is stick frozen on the nucleus. So they like the clothes, they never can have flow motion to share the nuclear motion. And this is one. The second one is the light is ice must play the basic function about the whole property. How the, let us say, the BCS theory also have Cooper pairs. What mean Cooper pairs? Cooper pair just the two electrons compared together, you know, compared together, become one pair. But that's amazing because the electron, all the particles, negative charge, you know, they will be expanding. Why they couldn't overcome? Because the light is ions, the vibration, they release the phonon. Actually, the ions is deformed. They give the energy to one electron, give another energy to electron. They let the media, you know, and pull them together. So one is, another amazing thing, so one is electron speed up. The spin is up. One electron is spin down. The spin equals zero. So the same effect equals zero. There's a magnet moment equals zero because the angle momentum equals zero. So when the Cooper pairs slow the EM field, they are look like the neutral particles. They never affect by the E field or M field again. So they are not scattering, they are not, they don't have the, you know, collision. So that's the reason the superconductor can come up. The resistance equals zero. That's all about it. So let us see the, that's amazing. Let us see the, you know, macroscopic quantum, the superconductor, everything like the one person, all of, the thermal motion totally eliminated. Every particle, yes.
Okay, so, because these pair electrons have no net spin, no net angular momentum, no net magnetic moment, they can't shield this gravity magnetic field effect from the rotation of the nucleon. That's why you can only see it in superconductors. Is that what you're saying?
Part of it, right. Another part is because the Cooper pairs electron still belong to the here, that the core electron, this is the free electrons. Free electrons is, did you know, one molecule, they have nuclear, they have the core electrons surrounded there, like the shared, you know. The outside of the shared, they can go away. They are the free electrons, you know. The conductivity also is carried by these free electrons. The Cooper pair talk about these free electrons become the pair each other. The core electrons is frozen, just like a nuclear bar is closed. When nuclear motion, the clothes must follow them. So that's the reason we see the whole of the light is motion actually is nuclear motion. Is that clear? they have the two kind of electrons. One kind of electrons is confined nearby the nuclear, and another electron is free to move, you know.
And which one, and you're saying which one is it that shields this effect so we can't see it? Is it the core electrons? Or the
core electrons. Usually core electrons, they have the free motion, you know. And the field come in, they first elect the core electrons. So electrons share the nuclear motion. You cannot see it. So when they gave to me the only window we can see the gravity in the superconductor, what happened? Because when you know the Mason effect about the superconductor, when you apply the magnetic field usually just rotation, right? They never dispersion their energy. They never give energy to other people. They just change your direction, your motion, right? But only since they can give the energy is the magnetic moment, the effect. They can absorb the energy from the magnet field. In the superconductor, the magnet field really can, they say that the inside of the superconductor, the magnetic field nearly equals zero. That's Mason effect, right? They actually is absorbed all the energy. Who absorbed the energy? Is it Cooper pairs? Usually is the electrons. Electrons have spin. Spin, they have the magnet moment, right? So they can interaction with magnet field. But when they become the Cooper pairs, they are the magnet moment equals zero. Can they affect with the magnet field? Can they absorb the energy from them? No. They just can direction the, so they flow in the penetration layers, you know, and the light will flow. Only can absorb the energy is the lattice ions. Lattice ions absorb a lot of energy, spin there up, very, very spin there up. So they will be produce a lot of the gravitomagnetic field. Also spin, you know, that is time variation. So when you use magnetic field, align all of the lattice ion in the same direction, so they can produce AC gravity. I calculated, and Professor Kip Sun in the Caltech, they come back and they have one formula also he calculated. His result is different than my result, because he didn't consider about it the energy conservative, how the lattice ion absorbed the energy. So everything is we calculated, we think the superconductor can produce the observed AC gravity. The AC gravity can let us control it. You know. So if you want to produce AC gravity, you need three conditions. One, you must have the superconductor become the tools. Second, you must have the AC EM energy source to supply this source. Third, this energy must have the high frequency can follow up the nuclear motion. If too high, the nuclear cannot follow up. Too low, nuclear doesn't affect. So you must have the certain frequency. So these three conditions is by accidentally is a Finland physicist named Pantelantonov. He do the superconductor, you know, experimental. Then they used the 12-inch superconductor disk rotated. They measured the AC Mason effect. And there have superconductor 12-inch, really huge mass. And they rotated. Also, they put the RF, the frequency power supply on it. And they levitated in the air. So then they found that everything they put up the desk have 4%, 2% the weight loss.
In mass. 2% loss in measured mass.
Yes. And
they don't believe yet. Nobody believes this. And he said that is experimental error. This must come from RF, you know, pressure. They must from the radiation, you know, from the EM effect, from anything. Then they finally change the sample. They put up, they use the wood, plastic, silicon, you know, everything in there. They found that everything lost the weight, 2%.
How fast were they? It was a disc,
12-inch
superconductor?
Yeah, the disc is rotating, 500 RPM.
How much?
5,000 RPM, sorry.
This was pretty fast. So, and they were, what was the frequency of the RF field?
10 to 6 to the 8th, I think, microhertz. 10 to 6 to 10 to 8.
10 to 8 hertz?
Hertz?
They use RF on this source, you know. 10 to 6 to 10 to 8 hertz.
Okay. A million to 10 million hertz.
Okay.
Well, if you use one of these to get rid of the burst magnetic field, what kind of energy input would you have to have?
We don't know yet, so far. But from my calculations, we know. I don't want to talk about it. I just want to tell you the. I just want to tell you already observed things.
So
they observed the 2%. If they put the two desks together, they produce 4%.
So what you're saying is that this your theory it seems to be an adequate explanation for the experimental results that the pin saw.
They
have the same three conditions that your theory requires, right?
Yes. Then if you can put the two superconductor desks, they produce 4% with the loss. And the NASA headquarters, you know, call me say, what we can do for the 2% or 4%? Then my son listen, you know, when they call my home, my son said, if 4% you can reduce the weight, if I go home to back, where are the American citizens, by the way, from China, you know. So if we fly from America and go back to China, I can save a lot of the fuels, you know, save a lot of energy. And that's just a charity answer. But I say that is initial. If we can do the 4%, 6%, actually we can achieve to control the gravity.
Yeah, well, even if this was something that was impractical for reducing the effective mass of a vehicle, if you stacked up 50 of these things, if it's 2% each time, you could create a small region of microgravity, zero gravity here on the Earth. To do an experiment.
I told you, the Senator John Glenn called me and said, hey, because the news, you know, come from Britain, so the whole of the world knew it. That became the international race, you know, everybody tried to cut the gravity control it. And I think America in the second position now. You know, the Germany and the Japanese is do much faster than us. Then Senator John Glenn called me said that's his 25 years dream. He wanted us, did you know, all of the aircraft, the shuttle, all of the missions, they want over the gravity, you know, go to space, you know, the airplane. If we control the gravity, we can go anywhere we want. So he said that is his 25 years dream. Then the last week, you know, Oak Ridge National Lab invited me to go there, give a talk. Then they told me, he said that is the 20 years dream. I said you have 5 years less than the John Glenn's dream. And actually, I think the status about this project, honest with you, the theory is there. The
still have a lot, that's very controversial, still have a lot of the professor, very famous, that agree this theory. All of them agree we need a test, the theory is right or wrong. You know, use experimental test. But accidentally, the phone line is got the result and can explain the theory. So only things we need to do, we need to confirm Fernline experimental result, then establish this theory. When this theory accepted by the society, then we can think of how to increase the effect to the anti-gravity to the commercial use yet. My situation is still in the controversial. I'm not to say that is a bright future. We don't know yet. I told our team, until we got 100% reproduced result, we will be published. Otherwise, I don't want to become the, another cold fusion like everybody. I think that's the best name because you can control it. Somebody wants to say gravity control. I said, you just want to control the Earth's gravity. Actually, I want to produce gravity in the space. You know, what I want. I want to direct the space shuttle go anywhere they want. Okay.
Can you also control inertia?
Inertia? Did you know that you...
mass.
The equivalent principle is what they talk about. They say inertial mass equals gravity mass, right? If I can control gravity mass, sure, since if the equivalent principle is right, I can control, you know, I can create, actually create another inertial frame. Actually, inertial frame, just you saw the different result in the different frame, you know. And, okay.
Do you control the fuel's mass as it moves the rocket nozzle?
Oh, I beg your pardon?
Did you control the fuel's mass as it moves the rocket nozzle?
We don't know. I never saw that one, well, you know. Okay.
You can also create gravity. You were saying that you could create gravity in space.
Yes, and I want to give the result. I never used this one before. So that is a basic formula, you know. And if you have the A is the gravitational vector potential field, you know, and you have the time change in this field, the mu is magnetic permeability, you know. The superconductor, the permeability nearly equals zero. So that's the all I talk about is reflected in this. If they zero, they increase the magnitude a lot. So that's the final result, the formula in the physics fundamental. This formula published already in the physics foundation letter.
Just so I get this right, you take this experiment where you got the spinning disk, RF excitement, you get 2% mass reduction within a certain distance out of it. If you were to move this to a microgravity field, zero gravity, and did the same thing, you would get what?
Kinetic.
You would get you experience a force in a direction without expanding reaction mass. Right? Is that what you're saying? You can move an object in space without interacting with electromagnetic field in space and without reaction mass. Is that correct?
Sir, I think that you think much further than what I think. I just want to
finish. That's what you're interested
in. Yeah, that's. I think that have a lot of the application about it.
If that's true, that can cause industrial revolution.
Oh, yes. That's an understatement.
So we don't need a car, we don't need an airplane, don't need a shuttle space. Everybody wear some superconductor shoes. Just go anywhere, fly in the air. Okay, that's
it. The last formula you had up there, what was the T in the...
T is time.
Time, okay. What was the A?
A is the magnetic vector field. Okay,
so... Proportionally, at what distance does the 2% gravity fade out so you're back to normal?
Okay, the, according to Pantelidon from the papers, all of the superconductor up the space, even the second floor, they can manage it. So that's the inertial frame is really very, very high. And above second floor, they say they couldn't manage it.
That's pretty high proportionally, isn't it?
His experimental, he took out the superconductor desk out. Let's say anything running, there are no this effect. They put the superconductor back, no energy source, there also no that effect. All the three conditions together, they saw this effect. Okay.
Can you put the slide
back up in
the
corner, please? Oh, sure.
So is that a...
The mu is permeability.
Is that a dt or,
partial t, partial t.
What is e? Partially, partial t.
Partially, partial t.
Okay. And what is e again, e sub q?
What's e?
E? What is e?
It's
the sleep
e.
What is
e? E. This one?
Yeah.
That's the AC gravity field. Yeah.
Okay, so we're saying as the permeability is very, very small, superconductor, small variations in the potential field causes a large gravity effect.
Exactly. Only superconductor provide us the tools. If no superconductor know this effect.
What is your experiment? Are you doing it more of as a gravity shield or a reduction in reverse force?
What you say?
With the other question, you're thinking of it as more of a reverse force. Is it more like a gravity shield, stopping gravity from reaching it, that 2%?
Okay, there are the conditions. It's up, produce up a field.
Yeah.
So that's reduce the gravity field. That you can call it shield or reduced. But actually, you can control the direction about the, you
spin, know. Spin the disk the opposite way, will the effect be the opposite direction?
No, actually, it's this. Oh, okay. Here I have some, actually, it's determined by how you apply the field. And I want the conclusions. And here have some the, here have the some we take the picture. That one is the. I think I put back this one. I can talk about it. Here this is the first American, the biggest superconductor desk we made it, and we use 3 million psi. The hydraulic press, that is very huge, you know, to make this big desk. The Finland experimental desk made by Russian. The Russian said they used 3 years to make it. We just used 6 months, you know, to produce this guy. We made two, so that's producible, you know.
What was the diameter?
12-inch diameter. You can see the hydraulic press is surrounding, is huge, you know, like the six. We use this one, this gravitometer can measure the gravity, you know, changes. Their sensitivity, they say, they can go to the energy, you know, 10 to minus 90. Design this die is really the So I designed with them, some company now applied the patent because make this desk really not easy, you know. Have a lot of trick work needed to do. And here is the two desks that reproducible, we made it, you know. And the superconductor, that is the Y123. The high TC superconductor, you know, all of the things. We cannot talk about here about the result. Please forgive me. I hope next year I can bring the data to everybody to repay back this, you know, permission. And okay. Yeah.